Here now with analysis and commentary on both those stories, Dane Cook. Dane?
Yes. I always feel so like I want to deliver some breaking news
there you go.
When I'm here.
Well, speaking of delivering, this new movie, American Exit, is really like a dramatic departure. You've done other stuff, but I don't think people would think, oh, Dane Cook, dramatic actor.
Yeah, yeah. If you're laughing at this, I'm in trouble.
Right.
It's absolutely something for me that it's in a lane that I've really never been in before.
What made you want to go into that lane?
Well, I've done a couple of films that people really liked. I did a movie with Kevin Costner, Mr. Brooks, very dark, kind of gritty. And I love psychological thrillers. And this movie played into kind of all the genres that I've always wanted to participate. So I was fortunate enough to get the gig.
And did you train as a dramatic actor?
For this particularly, I've never done like training, but for this, I hired somebody. He said, you should put on 30 pounds to play this.
Really?
You know, I have like dad bod. I was in good shape. So I just, you know, I did that. That was, if that's training, then.
You're in.
So Sylvester Stallone always says pancakes and milkshakes. How does one put on 30 pounds?
Oh, I did, can I say Chick-fil-A? I was like, just
really?
Whenever
oh,
I could.
Really?
Did you go to the one at Sunset and Highland?
I did, of course.
Okay.
But here's the thing, I'm 47. It used to just melt right off. It's like, oh, I can just get into the gym and like in 3 weeks.
No.
2 years later, I was like, I need to do keto or something.
Do you miss Chick-fil-A?
No.
Okay. All right, we're going to show a clip in a second. Log line, if this is the fair thing to say. Father and son, father's got a lot of problems, takes the son on a road trip that's supposed to be fun?
Or? Oh, not necessarily fun. It's definitely a crime thriller. It's
all right,
a crime thriller.
Here's a clip. Watch this.
He told her we're getting a divorce, and he left us on the same day. My mom didn't even know what hit her. I remember going to bed. And as I was falling asleep, I could hear my mother in the living room crying. But here we are.
That's a good scene,
yeah.
Because I think parents often do that, where you're like, you drop the bomb,
right.
And then, oh, and by the way, how was school?
And that's Levi Miller, by the way. Mm. He's an incredible actor. He was actually discovered 3,000 kids auditioned for Pan some years back, and he'd never acted. He got picked, but he's a phenom. He's unbelievable.
Now, was he aware of the other Dane Cook?
He learned as we were going. I mean, we got to know each other on the film, and then finally he'd be like, you know, I'm YouTubing you, and I'm finding all this. I'm like, some of it you can watch. Some of it is not for you.
And then I don't know if this is the blessing or the burden, but is there this expectation? You know, it's funny man Dane Cook.
Yeah, I mean, but I like to, you know, if I'm on a set, you know, I like to keep it light. You know, it's always great to do something that's intense like that. But, I go to work in a bit of more of a snappy mood.
the comedy stuff, you're doing a big tour in 2019.
Yes.
Dates all over the country, all over the world.
Everywhere. Right. At Radio City in the fall. It's just been the time of my life out there.
And then here's the thing. You came on the scene. You got really big.
Yes.
And then you tell me, do you think there were sort of the slings and arrows of envy or what? Because there was this sort of anti-Dane Cook contingent.
I think I was part of it at one point.
Right.
I was like, you get so exposed.
Yeah.
And it's positive in some sense because you want to build your fan base. But there's also that part where you're just worked finally till the point where you're like, where's my real original next idea? Mm-hmm. And that's always great to be able to take that break, reassess, you know, reassemble, and then come back with something like this tour that I'm doing, like this film, that's really more meaningful instead of just the machine of go, go, go.
See, I remember about 2 or 3 years ago, every other day, the phrase would be, Amy Schumer is having a moment. And there was, I don't know how you really live up to that.
Right. Oh, no, you just, when you're in that position, all you can do is, and then there's so much innuendo and stuff that's like, has nothing to do with you. I remember one time they were like, Dane Cook's dating Rihanna. I'd never met Rihanna. It was everywhere for like 2 days.
That must be so weird, right?
I literally never met her. Yeah. She might have come to a comedy club that I worked at. So you just kind of roll with it, and it's
now,
amusing.
Now, when it's a happy headline like that, did you subsequently call her up and say, actually, you should be dating?
No comment.
Okay. and then are the comedy audiences, do you feel, are they any different, or people just want to laugh?
Man, comedy audiences are, I feel like it's whenever, it's one of those things where whenever I get back out on tour, I feel like I grew up with a generation of comedians. I started in college crowds when I was 20, and I've literally grown to where now when I do a meet and greet, I'm meeting people that saw me when I was a kid, and now they're bringing their kid or their parents are with them. So there's something really incredible that's been happening in the comedy scene. I'm glad to be a part of it.
There we go. All right, American Exit out today on digital, DVD, and on demand. Dane's stand-up tour, Tell It Like It Is. Oh, nothing. Well, why don't you invite us to cover you July 20th in Hawaii?
That's perfect, yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, we're in. Yeah, we'll do a remote.
Well, yeah, we'll do a live remote. Fair enough. Good to see you, Dane.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. Thanks, Dane.
Thank you.